Hi, welcome to the TurtleSeg introductory video. In this video, we'll give you a walkthrough of a typical TurtleSeg use case, highlighting the main features as we go. I've preloaded the RIS CT volume image that is included with TurtleSeg. In this walkthrough, we'll segment the radius bone of the wrist. To begin, we'll adjust the window level of the image so that bones have a high contrast. This can be done by left-clicking and dragging the intensity start and end ranges in the sidebar. This should do. In TurtleSeg, objects of interest are identified by contouring around them within a 2D slice. We will add our first contour in the blue, top right slice view. We first zoom in by clicking and holding Ctrl-Shift left mouse button, and then panning by holding Shift left mouse button. We begin contouring by double left-clicking on the object's boundary. TurtleSeg uses Livewire to speed up the task of delineating a 2D object, so as we move the mouse, the Livewire will automatically snap to edges of objects. When the Livewire misbehaves, we can left-click to add a seed point, effectively anchoring the Livewire at that point. The contouring process completes when we click on our initial seed point again. With this single contour, we can now attempt to automatically construct a 3D segmentation of our object. We do so by going to the Actions menu and choosing Build 3D Segmentation. The segmentation build completes successfully, but the resulting 3D segmentation is poor. One user contour is often not enough for TurtleSeg to be able to construct a high-quality 3D segmentation, and that is what this message is saying. The dialog suggests that we invoke TurtleSeg's spotlight functionality to have it suggest a new 2D plane for us to manually contour, one that will improve the 3D segmentation the most. We click yes, and TurtleSeg then calculates the best suggestion plane. The flashing border around the bottom left slice view indicates the suggested plane. If we are not satisfied with TurtleSeg's suggestion, we can invoke Spotlight again to obtain a new suggestion. In general, we can ask TurtleSeg to suggest a plane for us by selecting Suggest Plane from the Actions menu. TurtleSeg calculates a new suggestion, and we accept it simply by starting to contour the suggested slice. While contouring this slice, the purple line segment that represents the previously added contour turns green on one end as we move the mouse over it. The green indicates that by left-clicking to place a seed point here, we would link our contour in construction with the previous contour, ensuring that they are consistent with each other. Alternatively, we can choose not to worry about this now, and let TurtleSeg attempt to link them automatically when we rebuild our 3D segmentation, which I will do now through the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-B. As you can see, the other end of the purple line segment turned green, indicating that it is now linked with the previous contour. In the 3D view, we can see that the resulting 3D segmentation has improved significantly, but it is still far from perfect. In order to improve the segmentation, we iterate over the process of adding a contour and rebuilding the segmentation. So, with the goal of adding a new contour, we ask TurtleSeg to suggest a plane for us again, this time using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-G. The red bottom left slice view is realigned to the suggested plane, and so we contour the object within this slice. Now that this is complete, we rebuild the 3D segmentation using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-B. We repeat this process a few more times, the segmentation quality improving over each iteration. The process is finished when we are happy with the quality of the final segmentation. This concludes the video walkthrough. Thank you.